Hello everyone, this is SQL Depository. I am Saurabh Pandey and you are watching video number 3 on Postgres administration. In the last video, we have deployed an Ubuntu AWS EC2 virtual machine, but if you don't want to use AWS, then you can also use VMware Workstation or Oracle VM along with Ubuntu ISO to deploy a virtual machine, and that will be completely free of cost. And then you can join me from this video. Okay, so let me go to the AWS console, and this is the virtual machine that I've deployed in my last video. If you see, the public IP has been changed because this is the on-demand instance, and the public IP is also associated with that instance is on-demand. So when your system is running, your virtual machine is running, the public IP will be associated with that. As soon as you will stop the virtual machine, the public IP will also go away, and then you will start the machine again, and then the new public IP will be assigned. Okay, so public IP will not be persistent in that case, but if you want to keep a persistent public IP, in that case you will have to block the public IP, then use the second NIC, attach that NIC to the virtual machine, and then your public IP will be persistent. But for that you will have to pay little extra, right? But this is not required for this video, so I'm not gonna do that. Now what I'm gonna do is I will select that virtual machine, click on connect, under the SSH client I will select the connection string, open command prompt. If you remember, the key pair file was downloaded under downloads folder, so I will have to redirect to that folder, and then the connection string, say yes, and you will be connected. Now the public IP of my laptop has not been changed, this is why I was able to connect. But if in your case you have changed the network and the public IP has been changed of your laptop, then in that case you will have to edit the security group and create the SSH rule for your new public IP. For me, it was not required, so the virtual machine is connected. Now, as you have already seen that I'm connecting using the key pair file, the .pem file every time. But what if I want to connect using the password authentication? So for that, first I will have to enable the password authentication, and for this, I will have to edit the config file of SSH. So for this I will type sudo. You don't have to write any command. I will provide all these commands in the description. You can go ahead and copy all these commands and run in your environment to install Postgres. Okay, so I'm gonna run sudo etc ssh sshd underscore config, and I want to edit this file. So for this I will use nano editor, but if you are more comfortable with vi editor, you can always go ahead and use vi editor. Hit enter, search for password authentication. So it should be somewhere here. Okay, here it is, and right now you can see password authentication is no. I will change it to yes, then I will save the file. Now the file is saved, but new configuration has not been loaded yet. So for this, you will have to restart SSH service. And for this, I will write sudo systemctl restart sshd. And now the service is restarted. Now you can try connecting the password authentication, but right now I don't have any user which I can use to connect this virtual machine using the password authentication, because I only have the Ubuntu user and we have not set any password for the Ubuntu user yet. So for this I will type sudo passwd ubuntu, hit enter, then create the password, and you are done. Now, if you open another command prompt and copy the connection string again, but this time I will not use the key pair. I will remove that. And hit enter. It will ask me for the password. And it is asking for the password. Let me give the password. And then I should be able to connect. Okay, now I'm connected. Now I'm good to install Postgres on this virtual machine. But when I will install Postgres, the installer will create one user with name Postgres. But when installer will create the user, it will not create the home directory. So what I'll do, I'll first create the Postgres user, then I will do the installation so that the home directory will also be created along with the user. So for this, I will have to type sudo add user, the username, then hyphen hyphen home, and then the home directory, which is home Postgres. Right now there is no directory with this name. I will have to give the password for the user, the full name. So full name is gonna be Postgres. Then just enter, hit enter, and you are done. The Postgres user has been created. Now you can start the installation using the Postgres user, or you can do the installation using Ubuntu user as well. So I'm gonna use the Ubuntu user only for Postgres installation, because it does not matter. You just need the root permission. So first thing that I will have to do, I will have to install software certificate for secure SSL. This has nothing to do with Postgres installation, but it is required for SSL. So I will run this command. Again, I will give this command in the description, so you don't have to type any command. Hit enter. This is done. Now you will have to import the repository signing key. And this is the command. I will copy this. Then execute. Then the last command, which will list out all the Postgres instances. And you are done. Now you are good to install Postgres. But before installing Postgres, I'm gonna update the virtual machine, which is always a good practice in Linux. So for this, I will type sudo apt-get update. It should only take few seconds. And once this is done, I will install Postgres instance. Okay, it is already done now. So I will type sudo apt-get install Postgres SQL. Okay, so now here, if you want to install the latest version, this command is good enough. But if you are targeting any particular Postgres version, then you will have to provide the proper version name here. So just for an example, if you want to deploy Postgres 14, then you will have to give this name, Postgres SQL-14. And in that case, it will install Postgres 14 for you. But I want to install the latest version, which is 15. So I will just use this command and hit enter. Type Y. And it should not take much time. It should be done in maybe a few seconds. And till then, what I'll do, I'll go to the another command window. And here I will exit from Ubuntu user. Then I will try to connect using Postgres user, because we have already created the user. So we should be able to connect using Postgres user. So hit enter. It is asking for the password. Give the password. And you are connected using Postgres user. Now you can see, as you can see, the Postgres installation is already done. So let me try to connect the Postgres instance. So for this, I will type sudo hyphen u Postgres, then psql. I have to give the username and everything, just because I am connected using Ubuntu user. Ubuntu is not a Postgres user. It is just a virtual machine user. So Ubuntu cannot directly connect to the Postgres instance. But if we are connecting using Postgres user, then in that case, we just have to type psql, hit enter, and you will be connected. But if I'll do it here where I've connected using Ubuntu user, let me quit from Postgres first. And if I hit psql, it will throw the error. As it was expected, because Ubuntu is not the user of Postgres. Okay. So I think this is pretty much what I wanted to cover in this session. In the next video, we will restore a sample database. We will download and restore a sample database named DVD rental, and also we will cover the architecture of Postgres. Thank you for watching this video.